Hello, everyone. As you may have heard or seen, there have been even more developments in the modding community for Jurassic World Evolution. What you're seeing on the screen now is me editing the map terrain of Isla Muerta all the way down to the beach line, because a brand new mod has come out called the Island Expansion Mod by the Toho Society, which expands your islands way out farther than they used to be able to go. So this will allow you to build dinosaur, or, you know, enclosures and hotels down on the beach line. It allows you to flatten many of the mountains and hills that are, you know, usually in our way. What I'm flattening right now is the mountains that divide the normal part of the park with the expanded part of the park. And I was just messing around to see what I can and can't do, and it turns out I can do a lot more than I was expecting to be able to do when I first saw the mod. It's really awesome. I mean, some of these mountains aren't too hard to get down. Even this big one falls eventually. I'm not sure if I do it right now or not. But yeah, I mean, see, it comes out pretty well. So these mods are really, really interesting. I really like them. They do kind of have, like, their issues right now, but it sounds like the modders are working on fixing that, hopefully. And hopefully it's something that can be fixed. The biggest thing is on reload of a save file, things get wonky. And I'll show you what that means in a little bit. You'll see. I mean, when you're right along the edge of the map area, you know, stuff starts to kind of get weird, but I'm not entirely sure there's anything that can actually be done about that. And if you just build up the land around it, it keeps it from looking odd. But, but other than that, I mean, like, you can totally build out into the water. You can pull up the land that's underneath the water, which will be cool because we could have enclosures out there. You could have hotels out there. All kinds of interesting stuff. I promise you, you'll see some dinosaurs in this soon. I was just kind of using this as backdrop while I talk about the mod. But yeah, this is what you're seeing right here is all area that you wouldn't have been able to build on previously. This is I'm removing the trees on the huge mountains behind the normal park area, so that's really awesome. This area could be flattened out a little bit, and you could have, like, some hotels up here, or, you know, your helipads and stuff like that. Like, definitely a lot of potential. Let's see, so I jumped forward, and as you can see now, all of those trees are taken off, and I stuck a helipad up here, it's the entryway. I'm using, the Mixed Eras mod in the Jurassic Park, version of the Sandbox Park. And so far, the Mixed Eras mod, Danny Bob's Environmental Overhaul mod, Mr. Chudon's fence mods, the Invisible fence mods, all that stuff, those, you know, the big mods that I use all the time, all working great. They don't seem to conflict at all with any of the, with any of this mod's files, so that's great. So you know, messed around for a little while, I wanted to get some dinosaurs out just to see how that would roll, you know, how their behavior is, because I was kind of curious, and I sort of proved my curiosity correct, is how dinosaurs behave in, like, the new areas where they couldn't go before. Obviously, there's no AI changes, but it definitely seems like they don't recognize that they're in an area where they can walk around it sometimes. And so I don't know if that's something that's fixable or not, or something we just have to deal with. I mean, there's a lot that I'm willing to put up with, quote unquote put up with, but, you know, deal with, work around, however you want to say it, in order to have an expanded part, you know. So I put this T-Rex out, and then I realized it didn't have any mod on it, and how silly is that? Not have a mod on a T-Rex, so I saved the game, closed it, put in the mod, reloaded, and this is what I came back to. Everything had been flattened, which, as you saw just a minute ago, was not the case when I left the game, and my helipad was floating. So I was a little surprised by that and a little bummed by that, because, you know, if you put anything up there, that can mess with things. As you can see, also, all of this right here that's green was sand. I had retextured it to be sand, and now it's all back to being grass again. What it didn't change, though, was the actual physical changes I made to the terrain. But it did revert back to the other brushes that I had covered up. So that is kind of a bummer, because it means that you could pretty much lose a bit of work that you've put into it. And I did save, just so you know, so it's not like I didn't save and that's why it didn't keep my changes, but, you know, it made that change in the background, too, to flattening all those mountains, which, I mean, if I wanted those mountains flattened, would have been a great, you know, service to me, but I did not. So, so I got the stand mod on the T-Rex, because if we're having these big modded park, we might as well have big modded dinosaur, and I was curious how far I could put them, even with water there. And it's not surprising that you can put the dinosaur all the way out into the water, because now it recognizes that area as buildable land. So, just for the heck of it, I put the T-Rex out there, because I wanted to see if he'd walk back, or where he'd walk. You could see back there, behind the landing spot, there's some built-up mountains and or hills, and I did that, building up the terrain from under the water. So it is possible. I will say, though, it is difficult. It's a bit time-consuming. It's a bit hard. Thankfully, it did not get, you know, from the save reloading and all the weird things happening to the train. Thankfully, that train was not affected. So that's good, too. So there's our T-Rex under the water. Stan is like, what's going on here? Why'd you do that? Why am I here? Poor guy. He seems very fussy. I can't remember, like, the T-Rexes being this fussy. So I can't help but wonder if the AI is, like, stuttering. Like, he's just very noisy. And then, after having a quiet contemplation, he's like, screw this, I'm going to sleep. So he had himself a nice nap. Not a care in the world. He's like, yeah, whatever, sleepy, sleepy. After his nap, he started walking in the opposite direction of the food, even though he is quite hungry. So that leads me to believe that there is some, like, pathing issues, maybe, and I'm not sure if that's something that can actually be fixed. Like, I don't think the AI recognizes that it can walk from where it is to the beach. But, I mean, if you're putting dinosaurs out here, it's totally fine. You just kind of got to know where your areas are. So now the helicopter is under the water, bringing it back, because I felt bad. And while that was going on, I had a second T-Rex in there, yeah. Now this T-Rex, after I opened, released the T-Rex, opened the gate, it wouldn't come out. And I don't know why. There's food nearby, and it was hungry. And I don't know why. Eventually what I end up doing is removing, like, the fencing, and it comes out. But for quite a while, it just hung around in there, even while it was starving and thirsty. One thing that definitely needs to be noted is that the dinosaurs do not, as far as I can tell, recognize the ocean as drinkable water, which, I mean, to a point is totally true, because it's salt water and that's not going to be good in the long run. I don't know if that's something fixable or not, or if it really matters, because they shouldn't be drinking salt water anyways. But you do need to have water sources, even if they are along the coastline. That T-Rex totally almost died from dehydration. So this is me reloading, or saving, and I reloaded the game again because I was hungry and went to go eat some dinner. And when I came back, the hills were back, which is great. although it did change some things in kind of a funny way. It's kind of dark because of the shadows, but you should be able to see. See, they just zoom right up it, and we're good. So obviously there's some issues. Oh, I think I went in for closer capture mode. Look, when this woman, yeah, get her go. Oh, there's no 90 degree angle here. No, all good. Bless the AI. This to me is the biggest bummer at the moment, because if the terrain keeps changing and everything is wonky like that, then you potentially can lose a lot of hard work. So this is the, okay, so if you can see in the background, I took the fence down, and the second stand is out and meandering and would not come down. I thought maybe the incline was too steep. The area that it's in right now is the normal area of the game. As you can see, a lot of the terrain mapping that I did, or brush masking that I did, is gone again since I reloaded. So what I did is I made like a land bridge to see if that would, and put some meat on there to see if that would encourage stand number two to come down. Stand number one is kind of standing there like, don't even know what's going on. So, where's my buddy? And then all of a sudden, stand number two just runs down, but completely disregards the food, even though it's both starving and thirsty, and does make a beeline for the water. So, you know, I don't know. I don't know if it's the mod. I don't know if it was just a weird day with the T-Rex. I don't know, but I have a feeling it has to do with where the AI is programmed to walk. I have no idea if that's fixable. Who knows? As you can see there from the stats, like, that dinosaur was losing health, but was still hanging out up there for a large portion of the time it was out. So, yeah, I don't know. And then once these were both down here, they never went back up. Even though I don't have any fences or anything, they never went back up to the floor. So, you know, that's something to keep in mind, like, how you build your enclosures. Like, I think at this juncture, building an enclosure that is only on a new part, or only on the old part, might be the best way to go about it. But until that, the changes that occur when you reload your save files get fixed, I don't know how I feel about building with the expanded maps. I think I will play around with some, you know, with how to extend the land and stuff like that for practice, but it seems like a lot of effort to go through for it all to potentially change. But the Toho Society does know about the save issue, the loading issue, and it is something they are working on. So hopefully in the future we'll see that fixed. And honestly, if that is fixed, then everything else is just stuff you work around. All in all, I see this as an amazingly awesome mod that will totally be great for this game. It just, they just gotta work out some of the kinks. I mean, this is a massive undertaking, so there are definitely gonna be a lot of kinks to work around, and maybe not all of them will be fixable, and that's okay. Like I said, if we can get this flattening and unflattening of the land thing fixed, I think everything else will just fall into place, and we'll learn how to work with all the other things we may have issues with. So yeah, thank you so very much for checking out this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got some good information out of it, and hopefully we will see some fixes so we can all have these really awesome expanded parts real soon. So as always, thank you so very much for watching. I really do appreciate it. If you enjoyed this, please leave a like, subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll be back with more mods for Jurassic World Evolution real soon. Until then, have a good one.